Castor oil. When it comes to hair loss, what is the truth about castor oil? Does it work? And will you get your hair back? Which one should you choose? And what's the best way to use it? The answer to all of these questions is coming right up. Hey guys, Leon here from hairguard.com, where people who are worried about their hair loss go to regrow their hair. Just before we get into the video on castor oil, if you want to get access to the hair nutrition plan, then make sure to click the link in the description. You get 21 delicious recipes designed specifically for faster, stronger hair growth. The meals are loaded with nutrients like biotin, zinc, and collagen to make hair as thick and strong as possible. Now let's get into it. Guys, I want you to check out some of these before and after photos posted online by various users of castor oil. This man used castor oil for 4 months to deal with his diffuse thinning all over the top of the head. He applied the castor oil plus 3 drops of rosemary oil twice daily, and the results were pretty astonishing. This man also had diffuse thinning, and you can see the improvement in density and coverage. Now, the thing about castor oil is that it's not used exclusively or even primarily for male pattern baldness. Many men also use castor oil as a beard enhancer, you know, to fill in bald patches and improve the density of their beard. But most users are actually women, and they typically purchase it to treat thinning eyebrows or eyelashes. You can see the dramatic improvement of the eyelashes of this woman after 5 weeks of application. This woman applied castor oil on her eyebrows for close to 6 months, 3 to 4 times a week. The eyebrows basically filled in, at least enough to have a solid, continuous appearance to it. But many women also apply it on their hair. Some have no problems with hair loss, but they use it to grow their hair out quicker. Others use it to treat diffuse thinning or thinning at the temples. These are the before and afters that a woman shared after a little over a month of use. You can see on the left a thin part of the hair. She applied the castor oil every other night before going to bed. On the right, you can see the part has all but disappeared. She was, quote, amazed at the results. So castor oil is a bit like minoxidil plus latisse in one bottle. It'll basically promote hair growth wherever you apply it. But what exactly is castor oil? Well, castor oil is a vegetable oil extracted from the beans of the castor plant. This is a perennial tropical plant whose beans are actually poisonous when directly consumed. And they're highly poisonous since they contain ricin, one of the most toxic proteins known to man. The good news is that when you make castor oil, the ricin is left behind in the paste that forms the waste of the process. So there's absolutely no ricin in the oil. Castor oil is so widely produced and ubiquitous that it's actually used as an industrial material, which means that it's cheap, really cheap. You can get a high quality 16-ounce bottle of organic oil for $10 or $20. Depending on how much you use it, it should last you a few months. So guys, when it comes to purchasing castor oil for hair growth, there are 2 varieties to choose from. The first is standard castor oil, which you will see advertised as cold-pressed castor oil. It has a clear appearance to it because it's extracted from the beans without any heat treatment. The beans are simply pressed, and the oil is literally squeezed out of them in a purely mechanical fashion. The other major variety is Jamaican black castor oil, or simply put, black castor oil. They are the same thing. Here, the beans are roasted until they turn dark. After they're roasted, the beans are grinded to a paste, and this paste is then boiled. While the paste is boiling, the oil it contains rises to the top of the water, where it is then collected and then bottled. The ash that arises through the roasting process is retained in the extracted oil, which gives Jamaican black castor oil its distinctive dark appearance. The method of extracting the oil is popular in, you guessed it, Jamaica. In the description below, I've linked to 2 cool videos showing how these different varieties of castor oil are produced, so feel free to check them out. Now, both the cold pressed and the black castor oil are marketed for hair growth, including the hair, eyebrows, eyelashes, etc. So I know exactly what you're thinking. Which of the 2 varieties would we recommend? Guys, both of them seem to work and both have excellent user reviews. But if you ask me, I'd go for the least processed of the 2, which is the clear cold pressed oil. We just can't really see how roasting the beans and boiling their paste would be of any benefit. But it is easy to imagine how such a process would destroy many of the natural chemicals in the oil. So we can't really think of any possible benefit to the black oil. Guys, if you have any thoughts on this, we'd love to hear from you in the comments. Have you guys used castor oil? And which of the 2 was it, and what basis did you make your choice on? So how do you use it? Now, this oil is very rich and not the easiest to absorb. So Naturally, the best time to apply it would be before going to bed every night. If you have short hair, you can just rub it in or use a spongy applicator bottle. For long hair, we would suggest a long tip applicator bottle. After all, this stuff is only useful if it reaches the scalp. Now, a much less popular alternative to topical castor oil is actually drinking it. Castor oil is more or less like minoxidil. You apply it topically for targeted hair regrowth, but take it orally and you're likely to see generalized hair growth, including, of course, on the scalp and the beard. Now, if you do take it orally, then be prepared. This stuff tastes nasty and it has a horrible texture when you swallow it. So if you don't want to be dealing with the taste, a good idea is to put it in gelatin capsules. So used topically, this stuff is very safe with minimal to no side effects, at least for the vast majority of people who use it. But as with all topical treatments, there is always the possibility that you might be allergic to it. So if you haven't tried it before, then do a test application on a small test patch of skin and wait a few hours. If you don't get an allergic reaction, then you're good to go. Orally, however, it's a different story. When this stuff is marketed and sold explicitly for oral consumption, it's actually sold as a laxative, and that's either in a bottle or in gel caps, meaning that if you don't take a low enough dose, you will experience intestinal discomfort and even diarrhea. 5 milliliters is the reference dose to induce the laxative effects, so you'll definitely want to keep well below that. Ultimately, as there are no solid guidelines to go by, you will have to play with the dose to see what works best for you. Now, having said that, we would strongly advise against consuming castor oil orally. Even if you do manage to find a dose that seems to work for you without causing intestinal problems, its long-term effects when taken orally are simply unknown. It's a bit of a stab in the dark, and it's probably not worth it if you ask us. Having said all of this, it's that time again. Time for our verdict on castor oil. And we're actually going to give castor oil a thumbs up. Now, when it comes to the scientific literature on castor oil for treating hair loss in men, there is simply nothing. Literally, not a single published study has tested its efficacy on balding men, or women for that matter either, which is pretty unbelievable, considering just how popular this oil is for promoting hair growth with both sexes. But nevertheless, the great results that we're seeing posted by users online, its popularity, its low cost, and lack of side effects all combine to make this a very attractive proposition. Users of castor oil claim that it regrows new hair, thickens existing hair, and also accelerates the growth rate of the hair shaft. So if you're interested in a natural alternative to minoxidil, RU, topical finasteride, or any other harsh chemical, castor oil is definitely worth a try. If you have diffuse hair loss or long hair, it will be a bit of a pain to apply it, no doubt about it. But if you're like most guys out there with short hair and localized thinning, then it's a different story. You simply apply the castor oil on the thinning area prior to sleep and then rinse it off in the morning. For even better results, you can mix in a few drops of an essential oil. Rosemary oil and lavender oil would be two obvious choices. And if you're going to go down the natural route with castor oil, then it makes sense to combine it with an all-natural oral treatment, like saw palmetto or a saw palmetto-based supplement. In the description below, I'm gonna link to the saw palmetto max blocker formula. Aside from saw palmetto, it's got some of the most potent plant-based DHT blockers known to us, like the reishi mushroom, stinging nettle, and pumpkin seed. All the ingredients are sourced and extracted to the highest standards of quality, and it's got a 180-day money-back guarantee, so it's entirely risk-free to try. Guys, if you want to learn more about derma rolling or Will's 8 steps that he used to regrow his hair, then click the videos on the screen now.